So I was at the hobby store earlier today and I ran across this Pinewood Derby weight. And it's got kind of this cool industrial, kind of maybe sci-fi look to it. So I thought it'd be a cool thing to buy and then make a mold of, so I can make it out of resin or foam clay, because it's metal, it's got a little bit of weight, it's a little bit sharp. So I think it wouldn't necessarily be con safe, but once we make a mold of it, we have a bunch of different options for it and we can reproduce it. So we got our hot glue gun plugged in, we've got a small piece of foam core we're gonna use, and now I'm just gonna kind of plan out the basic shape. I think I'm just gonna go, give us a little room to work with, and we are just gonna go probably that big for this box. So we're gonna go ahead and cut it out. So we won't need much. I'm just gonna give myself a little bit of extra room. So there. So we'll measure out four of these, make sure they're all relatively the same height. You don't have to be perfect with it. Yeah, because I'm not filling it all the way up to the top. We're just gonna get it close. And what I'm gonna do is give myself a little mark where my fill line should end. All right. So, just gonna run a bead of hot glue right there. And then I put the foam core on it and I squished it around a little bit. And then I went back behind it and added another thing of hot glue. So I like to put the glue underneath as well as on the back, just to keep any leaks from happening. No matter what you do, sometimes leaks will still happen. So I like to keep the glue gun on and ready to go once I start pouring the silicone. So that way if a leak does appear, I can fill it really quickly. So I'm just giving the object a little bit of a wiggle, see if anything moves, everything feels stable. So we're all set for the silicone. So I just picked up the trial size of this Moldstar 30. So I want to give each bottle a really good stir, make sure I scrape up anything on the bottom, give it a good mix before I pour it into my measuring cup. All right, so we got part B mixed up. Next, we will do part A. So we've got a good mix going on, and we're gonna go right about there. So it looks pretty close to each other. We've got a little drippings on the side. So while these settle a little bit, what I'm gonna do is get some wipes and clean up the bottles, make sure those are nice and clean before I put them back on the shelf. Okay, so now we're just gonna mix. So we're gonna give it a good mix. So the good thing about Moldstar 30 is it's got a pot life of 45 minutes, which is plenty of work time. If you make too little, you can always make another batch and add it in. So it does take 6 hours to cure though. So it's a good project to do first thing in the morning, set off to the side. And if you got something else going on, you can still work on another project. All right, so I feel like we got a good mix. So we'll take our little piece. And I'm just doing a nice thin line, kind of make sure I get a good coating everywhere. I'm gonna use the tongue depressor to kind of make sure I get it in all those crevices. Okay.
It can be a little tricky sometimes, especially with how dark blue this is. It looks like it's completely covered, but when we take the tongue depressor and put it in towards the top, you barely got like a 16th of an inch in there. So that's why I always recommend putting a little line on your foam core or whatever to make sure it's nice and solid underneath. We got nice good coverage. We're spinning this around, make sure we don't see any leaks coming out of our foam core. We're okay for right now, so I'm going to set this off to the side. And then what I'm going to do is, since I'm done with all these, I'm going to mix all three cups together. That way there's silicone in it. That way when it cures, I can just pull the silicone out. And that way there's not like a raw chemical. So it's been a few minutes. I'm not seeing any leaks around here, so it's safe now to maybe move to a shelf and get it out of the way for the next few hours. So it's been over 6 hours. Feels nice and firm. So I think we're ready to pull the mold. It's a little bit like unwrapping a Christmas present. Okay, so we did have a little bit of silicone seep under where we had the glue. That's not a big deal. It's very thin. And everything looks good. Our piece came out well. So we just got to clean up that little bit of flashing where the silicone seeped under the piece and the piece of foam core. So I'm just taking a look in, making sure I don't see no air bubbles or anything. But so far it's looking like a really successful casting. And I think we're gonna do a quick test pour and see how we did. So it's been a few minutes since we casted this, and it's all fully cured, so we're ready to pull. All right, it came out super easy, so now I'm just giving it a once-over, making sure we don't have any air bubbles or anything like that. But it looks pretty good. There's a little bit of flashing we might have to clean up, but other than that, it looks like a pretty good pull. So we can give it a good dry brushing with like metallic paint, maybe some rub and buff. And we're set to go. So thanks for hanging out with me today while I went through a basic mold setup. Hopefully you guys found it helpful. And if you did, hit that like button, smash that subscribe button, and I'll see you next time.